The New York Times just interviewed Jimmy Carter. Libs hate him now for what he said about Trump, the NFL, and Hillary, lol. Ever since the election, Democrats have been in full meltdown mode as their standard bearer, Hillary Clinton, lost to a man who had never held office before. They've screamed impeachment, Russian collusion, and of removing President Trump for incompetence via the 25th Amendment. Over 90% of mainstream media's coverage of Trump has been negative. Every day, liberals screech how Trump is destroying America, while facts show the stock market at an all-time high, jobless claims the lowest since 1973, ISIS is all but defeated, and the entire UN Security Council voted to impose crippling sanctions on our enemy, North Korea. We could go on, but the point is, the nation is thriving under President Trump, and he's only been in office for a little over 9 months. Yet Democrats still screech. Well, all but one, apparently. The New York Times recently interviewed former President Jimmy Carter. Carter, a Democrat, and well known as the worst president in U.S. history, until Obama came along, had some interesting words about President Trump, Russia, the election, and Hillary Clinton. He didn't exactly toe his party's line in the interview, and libs are surely shitting their collective pants in horror. Carter, at 93, apparently feels he's old enough now too. Wait for it. Tell the truth. Truth, not being one of the Democratic Party's strong points, is strange to hear coming from one of its own, but today, it's happening. Prepare to have your socks blown off. Here's what Carter had to say. Via the Daily Wire. At 93, Jimmy Carter is cutting loose. The former president sat down with the New York Times recently and chatted about all kinds of subjects. The Times decided to play up the fact that Carter, one of the worst presidents in U.S. history, would love to go over to North Korea as an envoy. But the Times is steadily proving how out of touch it is, and how it no longer seems to actually get what real news is. Here are some major highlights from the interview. 1. The Russians didn't steal the 2016 election. Carter was asked, "Did the Russians purloin the election from Hillary?" "I don't think there's any evidence that what the Russians did changed enough votes, or any votes," Carter said. So the hard-left former president doesn't think the Russians stole the election? Take note, Capitol Hill Democrats. 2. We didn't vote for Hillary. Carter and his wife, Rosalynn, disagreed on the Russia question. In the interview, she looked over archly, and said, "They obviously did purloin the election." "Rosie and I have a difference of opinion on that," Carter said. Rosalynn then said, "The drip 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 about Hillary." Which prompted Carter to note that during the primary, they didn't vote for Hillary Clinton. "We voted for Sanders." 3. Obama fell far short of his promises. Barack Obama whooshed into office on pledges of delivering hope and change to the country, spilt, sick, bipartisan politics. He didn't. In fact, he made it worse. He made some very wonderful statements, in my opinion, when he first got in office, and then he reneged on that, he said about Obama's action on the Middle East. 4. Media harder on Trump than any president. A recent Harvard study shows that 93% of new coverage about President Trump is negative. But here's another shocker, Carter defended Trump. "I think the media have been harder on Trump than any other president certainly that I've known about," Carter said. "I think they feel free to claim that Trump is mentally deranged and everything else without hesitation." 5. NFL players should stand during the American anthem. Carter, who joined the other four living ex-presidents on Saturday for a hurricane fundraiser, put his hand on his heart when the national anthem played, and he has a strong opinion about what NFL players should do, too. "I think they ought to find a different way to object, to demonstrate," he said. "I would rather see all the players stand during the American anthem." Is that crazy or what? The former president, a Democrat, almost sounds like a booster for Trump. Carter, of course, comes from an earlier time in our history when politics weren't so caustic and we didn't have the likes of BLM Dem reps Maxine Waters and Frederica Wilson screaming that the president and a four-star Marine general are racist. Democrats could surely learn from Carter's tone and willingness to concede to the truth, but I highly doubt they will anytime soon. Dems now just have to stew in their own pot, knowing that one of their own basically just told them all to shut the fck up. LOL. Share this if you think Dems should listen to Carter more often. By Jeff Rainforth.